hearing these bell-like sounds in his mind. And then, after a couple of minutes, his head starts to clear a little bit. He starts to feel a little bit better. And the bells start going away. And as he sits there, he looks down to his left and he thinks, oh my God, there's my cat. That'll help me come back to reality. And he starts petting his cat, his beautiful furry black cat. And he's petting his cat and looks down and he says, I love you, my little cat. My poster not back. At least you're still here with me. And he says, I love having a cat. I love cats. I love having a pet. I love having a pet cat. As a matter of fact, I wonder how long people have been keeping cats for pets.
From the time of the ancient Egyptians until today, many people have been cat fanciers. You are such a person. Your cat is a big, beautiful black animal. His appearance as much like a panther as a cat. Your pet is a very friendly one. Each day as you come home from work, he shows you his affection by purring and rubbing his sleek fur against your legs as you reach down to scratch his head. Until one day...
Past a family of four, a young child and a tiny, tiny little cat. So soft and tiny. I keep walking, and there beside me is a tray of hors d'oeuvres, and I'm so hungry, so I grab one. I'm late for sound check, so I must keep walking. Pop the thing in my mouth. Keep walking and realize there's something between my teeth.
something furry. And I pull that out of my teeth, and then there's a little more, and then I realize that, unfortunately, I ate that cat. It was tiny, and it was a little poster nutbag.
Look! The storm's gone.
Jimmy? Yes, Dad?
Jimmy, I have some bad news for you.
What is it, Dad?
It's about your cat.
Little PM?
Philosophical. He thinks, how did I get here?